In the old days, when I was building out my home lab, I used to gravitate towards old used enterprise gear because it came with something called IPMI built right into the motherboard. That gave me a keyboard, mouse, and video access to the remote machine no matter where I was over the network. However, these days, you can do that exact same thing with something like this. This is the GL.iNet Comet. This is the PoE version I have right here. So essentially, you can power this little box using just nothing but this Ethernet port right here from your PoE switch. And then you connect up the HDMI input and the USB input directly into the back of your computer, and you can control the thing as if you were sat physically at the console of the machine. Now, the cool bit for me at least is that this thing can run Tailscale. So, guess what? We're going to plug this in, see how it works, and try and get Tailscale set up on this bad boy in today's video. Now, I'm not expecting setup to be terribly difficult today. The box comes with everything that you need to get started, which includes an Ethernet cable, an HDMI cable, and I'm actually happy to report, compared to some of the other options on the market, like the Jet KVM, that this uses full-size HDMI. It's always a, you know, it just takes the edge off the Jet KVM for me, is that you have to use that sort of mini, or is it micro HDMI? Anyway, and then this also comes with two USB-C cables, because even though this device is officially PoE rated, it's also got a little 5-volt, 2-amp USB-C plug on the side as well, in case you can't give it PoE power. So the ports on this thing are really straightforward. There's a USB 2.0 port, so if you want to mount any kind of storage, an HDMI in port, although there's no pass-through, which their more expensive Kickstarter-backed Comet Pro, which I'll put on the screen right now, that has 4K HDMI pass-through, so you could literally put this between the computer and a real physical monitor. So, I don't know, a parent's house or something like that might be really useful for that use case. You've got a USB-C port here for the HID device, the HID device, and then, of course, the Ethernet port for PoE in. And then on the side, it's just a 5-volt, 2-amp USB-C plug. You see, it's pretty small, fits in the palm of my hand. It's not too dissimilar in size, possibly slightly smaller than their typical GL.iNet slate, like travel routers that they make as well. So let's get this thing powered on and see what it does. Okay, so the thing is powered up. I'm going to go through this in real time with you just to show you how easy or not this is to set up. No smoke and mirrors here. So I'm setting up a brand new username and password. Okay, well, there we go. I mean, it worked out of the box right away. I'm able to log in to my little Dell 1-liter PC. Okay, so far, so good. Fresh out of the box, it's running version 1.5.1. I don't know if that's the latest or not. Let's take a look in the settings and see what we've got. Okay, so quality, video quality is low, medium, high, ultra high. We can change, you know, some of the encoding settings, the orientation. I don't think I need to have a 1440p monitor hooked up when it's just the terminal. So I'm going to go for a standard 1080p 60Hz monitor. And what this EDID thing does is essentially when you connect up an HDMI cable to a monitor, it does a little communication back and forth over the HDMI cable and says, hello, my capabilities are X, Y, and Z. And in this case, I'm going to have the Comet. We have the Comet talk back to the Dell box over HDMI and say, right, my resolution is 1080p at 60Hz. We can have things like a virtual keyboard. Okay, cool. I don't think we need speaker and mouse. Now, if you are using this to monitor a system with a graphical user interface, you might actually find this mouse jiggle option useful. This mouse jiggle option will essentially just do the same, like it will prevent screensavers from running. Pretty useful, I think. And then beyond that, you know, you've got standard stuff like configuring the network and time zone and all that kind of stuff. So under toolbox, let's have a go. Let's grab some text. I don't know. Let's just copy this text into my remote device and see what happens. Whoa, that was fast. I don't know if you've ever tried to do that on the Jet KVM, but it's glacially slow. So that seems to perform pretty well. Okay, wake on LAN. This is interesting. So one of the things that this device doesn't do out of the box is it doesn't have any way of sort of connecting up through GPIO pins like maybe the PI KVM would have, Or even the Jet KVM as well has that option. And the Nano KVM. Now, see, there's so many in this space now. These things have really got to work hard to stand out in this space. So we can add a Wake on LAN device. And actually, my colleague Kevin Purdy wrote a whole post about how you can use Wake on LAN with Tailscale a few weeks ago on the Tailscale blog, which I'll link to down below. And then maybe for some reason I want to access the terminal of the Comet device itself. So if that's the case, I could just click on access and it'll drop me into a shell here. I don't know what capabilities I've got, but well, apparently I can run HTOP. So yeah, it could be useful for some basic troubleshooting. But let's do what we're here for. Let's go through, I don't think we need to worry too much about all this stuff. Mounting a remote ISO, very handy. Like if you need to reinstall the operating system remotely, the virtual media thing can be very handy. But what I want to do is turn Tailscale on. That's why I'm here. I watched, I think it was a Crosstalk video on this device, and I saw him playing around with Tailscale, and I was like, yes, I want this in my life. So I'm going to check the Tailscale button here and just see what happens. You're coming along for the ride with me. So we've started, I think what has happened behind the scenes there is I think we've started the Tailscale daemon. So let's click on bind device and see what happens. Well, okay, I'm instantly taken to a Tailscale login page. I'm just going to log into my Tailnet as usual, to be honest with you. And then, yeah, GL KVM is now a device in my Tailnet. Okay, let me rename this to something makes a bit more sense. I'm just going to call this Comet for right now. And then hopefully if I just go to Comet, yeah, just on port 443, so HTTPS, it'll be a self-signed certificate. Good to go. Yeah, there you go. So I can now access my Comet KVM via Tailscale. Pretty straightforward, right? I mean, it just worked as advertised. I wonder though, what else can we do with this? Okay, so I can run Tailscale as an exit node through the Comet. Actually, that's pretty interesting. Rather than running an Apple TV or something like that as an exit node, I can now route all of the traffic from my client devices out through the Comet in the network that the Comet sat in. Could be pretty useful. Would be handy though, if we could have Comet be backed by a proper TLS certificate, wouldn't it? So I wonder, can I drop into the terminal of the Comet and do Tailscale serve dash dash BG, well, I guess 443. I don't think that's gonna work actually, because if I do grep 443, the error message tells me it might have worked. I guess we'll find out in a minute. Yeah, plain HTTP request was sent. Let me go back to the toolbox and then access the terminal again. Now that failed because actually if I'd thought about it, the Comet's running on a self-signed certificate. So what we actually need to do is effectively do this, but just modify the command ever so slightly to be on the correct port. So let's do this and then modify this to be 443 and then do dash dash BG as well because I want it in the background. And now I'm hopeful that this will work. So there we go. All right, so it's just a couple of little tweaks. So because Comet is running a self-signed TLS certificate and the chain of trust doesn't end anywhere, like the CA that is generated as part of the self-signed certificate chain, there is no trusted CA as part of the TLS validation chain. We have to put that insecure option in there, but essentially you can now access your KVM, your GL.iNet Comet KVM with a full TLS certificate just by running this one simple command. Maybe that should be the title in the thumbnail. You won't believe this one simple trick. I will not do clickbait on this channel. It's just, I won't do it. That's my contract to you as the viewer. This is the command that you want here. So you drop to the terminal, which is found under toolbox and then terminal and access. And then you type this command in here, Tailscale serve dash dash BG to put it in the background. And then HTTPS insecure localhost port 443. And that's it. You can now access your KVM with a proper TLS certificate. So I think that's a really quick overview. I mean, I should also point out that GL.iNet have their own proprietary cloud service, which I don't know. I'm just going to use Tailscale because it's free and it works out of the box. Like, I don't need to use another cloud service unless I want to. Seems like a pretty good product, to be honest. Does exactly what it says on the tin. Is powered up over PoE. If you need the pass-through of HDMI, then it might be worth giving this a look. I mean, it's on Kickstarter, so here be dragons, you know. But GL.iNet so far have proven to be a trustworthy company, at least. So 4K, 30 FPS, pup, you know, 4K HDMI pass-through with a little screen that's actually very reminiscent of the Jet KVM as well. Looks like a good device. So that's my quick overview of the GL.iNet Comet PoE device. And as always, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, I've been Alex from Tailscale.